Chapter 5, Morphology of Flowering Plants. This is video 2. In video 1, we had studied about the different structures and types of roots, functions of root. And in this video, we'll be studying about stem. So, what is a stem? Stem is the aerial part of the plant and the plumule develops into stem. In the stem, there are nodes and internodes. You can see the nodes over here, node and internode. Between two nodes, there is internode. Node is that region from where the branches, leaves arise. And internode is the region between two nodes. Why branches, stems, leaves, buds arise from nodes? Because nodes contain meristematic tissues. And stems, you all know students, they are positively phototrophic. They are negatively geotrophic as well as negatively heterotrophic. That means they grow or move towards light, but they move away from soil and water. Now let's talk about bud. You all know that stem or young shoot, they bears bud. Buds are of two types, either vegetative bud or floral bud. Vegetative bud are the buds which give rise to branches, leaves, and floral buds are the buds which give rise to flower. Vegetative bud can be terminal or apical bud, which is present on the tip of the branch or the stem. And the second is auxiliary bud or lateral bud, which is present at an angle. The angle between the main stem and the branch or the leaf is known as axil. And over here, the bud present at the angle is known as the auxiliary or the lateral bud. Now, let us see to the function of stem. What is the function of the stem? The main three functions of stem. It gives supports to the plant. It conducts water and mineral, as well as it helps in the transport of food. There are some other functions of stem also. It stores food. It gives support to the for climbing of the plants, as well as it provides protection in the form of spines and thorns. Now, let us see the first, that is modification of the stem, underground stem. These are some modification of stem where the stem are produced below the ground. They get swollen up and they store food. This is tuber of potato, bulb of onion, rhizome of ginger, and comb of colocasia. You can see in this rhizome, there are scaly leaves. In the ginger, there are scaly leaves. The scaly leaves, scale leaves are produced at the node, and from the node itself, the roots are given out. These are the adventitious roots. So these are some of the underground stem which develop below the ground and they store food. Now let us see about some subaerial modification of plant. Subaerial modification means they will be partly below the ground and partly above the ground. Here we will be studying four types: runner, stolon, sucker, and offset. Let us take each one of them in detail. Runner. What are runner? Runners, they produce adventitious roots at intervals. You can see over here. You can see the cursor. These are the adventitious roots. And at nodes, below there are adventitious roots and above there is green leaves, scaly leaves as well as green leaves. and the internode is short. Example is grass, and it spreads to new niches, new areas when old parts die. It forms a new plant. Next, let's see stolon. You see this in strawberry. Generally, it is above the ground and often it is arched. You can see the arch over here. And the internodes are comparatively long. And because it is arched, it can overcome small obstacles. Then, next, offset. It is having a lateral branch with short internode, and at the node, the main feature is that at the node, below the ground, there will be a tuft of roots, but above the ground, there are leaves, which is arranged in the form of a rose, like in the rose, like petals are arranged. So we say rosette of leaves above the node and tuft of roots below. You see it in pistia and acorn. The next one is sucker. You see it in chrysanthemum and mint. Mint matlab dhaniya. And in this, there is a main shoot. You can see where the cursor is moving. This is the main shoot. The main shoot is erect. It is the main shoot, you can see over here. It is non-green and it is underground. It is erect. And from below the ground, you can see that this horizontal stem arises, shoot arises, which comes out and becomes straight to form a new shoot. And above the ground, there are leaves. This is sucker in chrysanthemum and mint. There is one more type of modification seen in stem, known as tendril. What are tendril? Tendril are cylinder spirally coiled part of the plant. You can see this. It winds around the support, and the auxiliary bud, it forms the tendril. It is a stem modification. Children, when you will be studying about leaf, you will see over there, even the leaves are modified sometime into tendril. So, stems can also get modified into tendril, and as well as leaves can get modified into tendril. And in stem, if the stem is getting modified into tendril, then the auxiliary bud, you can see, what did I tell you just now? Axil, the bud present in the axil. This angle is auxiliary bud, and this auxiliary bud gets converted into a tendril. This auxiliary bud may also get converted in few plants into thorns, where it the modification is that it protects the plants from browsing animals. It acts as a defense mechanism. Thorns are what? It are woody, straight, pointed structures. Like citrus plant has got thorns. Bougainvillea has thorns. So, I want to tell you one thing over here. The tendril of cucurbita plant and the thorns of citrus or bougainvillea plant, they are homologous organs. Reason, because both of them are derived from auxiliary bud, and but their function is different. So they are what? They are homologous organs also. With this, we finish the topic of stem. And the next video which I'll be making will be on leaves. Thank you.